Hey everybody, happy new year. I know it's been a while. I have been in hiding and planning some awesome stuff for 2025 here at Divi Engine to bring you more tutorials, more tools, and more fun things to help make your Divi life a little bit easier. And today is no exception. I'm coming to you with a tool that was released in November last year that I have kind of worked into my workflow when doing stuff. And that is, of course, with this big AI boom, the AI Assistance panel in Google Chrome. Now, we've got this article here that kind of outlines it, but basically what it does, it offers you AI assistance using the Gemini model by Google for things like styling, network requests, sources, and performance. So this, you can imagine, is gonna help out a lot because it does all of this in the context of the page that you're looking at. So what do I mean by that? Let's take a look. I will link this, of course, as I mentioned, in the description of this video, so you can go have a look and watch this cool video. I am gonna go here to the Divi Engine site. Now let's just refresh this to make sure it's also clean. And there we go. All right, so in its simplest form, let's take a look at how it can adjust the styling. Now, I'm not gonna go through every use case like the network tab and all that fun stuff. Maybe you can comment on the video and that you want something like that, then I'll go ahead and do it. So let's go ahead here, and I'm just gonna go ahead and inspect the page. Now, when you first try to start using the AI assistance down here, you might have to go activate it. You're in the settings, and you gotta go here to AI innovation, so you gotta switch these two settings to on, okay? Now, what's cool is you can also get console insights. So if you get an error in the Google console or the Chrome console, you can go ahead and ask us like, hey, what is this error about? So you'll see here, AI, understand this error. And then it'll say there the console message associated with track trace, related source code, yada, yada, yada. But that's what's interesting about this. So there might be something you don't understand and it's gonna start generating an explanation for you. Then it'd say, okay, well, yeah, it's failed to load. Here's the common causes. Looks like my ad blocker is at fault. So maybe when you're troubleshooting an issue on your website, you can actually go ahead and look at the console and maybe you'll see something related to AJAX filters or anything like that. That's gonna help you diagnose that issue. And then maybe you're like, okay, well, maybe I need to disable my ad blocker, reload the page, and if it's working, you found the culprit. It's not the actual plugin or WordPress theme or whatever you're using. It is the way that you are using a browser. Okay, so let's move on a bit. Okay, so I closed that. Let me just reopen it. Okay, back in here. Let's go to the AI assistant. And if you remember, I right-clicked and I inspected this element. And I can say something like, make this element smaller. And it's gonna go ahead and think of it. Now, it's not perfect. I'm gonna tell you that ahead of time that sometimes you need to massage it a bit, but it is very helpful. So you'll see it's analyzing my prompt and now it's analyzing the element. And there it tells you all these fun things and it gives you like this code to execute. Now, this is the code it's gonna execute to apply the style dynamically to your page. It's not the actual CSS they'd use, but you can click continue here and you can see that the style immediately changed. And what it does is tell you exactly what it did. Well, I reduced the font size to this and then it gives you like other options to like, yes, it's perfect or whatever. So yeah, let's go ahead and, you know, it gives you more options. But I'm gonna go ahead and reload the page again quickly because I wanna show you some other stuff that you can do with this to make your sites a bit better. So maybe on this element, let's right click this, inspect. Okay, so we've got the whole thing now. If you do wanna go back and more specifically select a specific element, you just click on this little selection tool here. So if I click this whole element, it does give you the entire selector. And then let's say, how do I add a scale hover effect that makes this larger when the mouse cursor is over it? And then it's gonna do the same thing. It's gonna do the thinking, implementing, and there we go. Now it says, okay, here's all the stuff we're gonna do. Let's go ahead and continue. Okay, so now it's got all that and there you go, it works. And now you can ask, give me the CSS. And there you go. Okay, well, it exports all of this again. So this is where the fun happens. Sometimes it's going to give you exactly what you want, and sometimes it's going to give you a bunch of JavaScript, you know, that they're using to implement this. But again, you know, this is just, you know, to further help you get through these things. So it'll take a little while to gather all the CSS elements, and it's thinking. You can actually go in here and see what it is looking at, the data returned, all that fun stuff. Okay, looks like this one got a little bit frozen. Oh, actually, there it is. And here you go. Here is all the information and all the CSS. Well, that's actually too much CSS, isn't that? Oh, here we go. Here is the hover style CSS. You can ignore all that other CSS and just utilize this. So you would copy and paste this, of course, in your theme options, in the module, and you can get even more specific by going ahead and adding a class to that column and then just adding that to the CSS here. And that would increase specificity. So that's actually quite cool, right? So there is a quick rundown of how this AI tool can help you out in achieving certain effects. So let's look at another use case where maybe we want to know how something is done. So let's go ahead and take a look at this site. Okay, so here I've got just like a Divi page that I threw together, and it's got three columns and two rows here, as you can see. Now, something that we see a lot is people asking, how can I vertically center elements in a column? And we do have some snippets for that on the Divi Engine snippet blog. You can check that out, linked in the description. And let's take a look at how the Chrome Tools AI assistance can help you with that. So we're going to go ahead and inspect the page again. And sometimes it'll happen that you have closed the AI. So you just click these three dots, you go to More Tools, and then you just select AI assistance. Okay, so we want to make sure we select the right thing here. So we're going to go ahead and make sure that we select our column, and then we're going to tell it, how do I center the elements in this column vertically? And our experience has taught me to add the following line, give me the full CSS at the end. Because sometimes what it'll do, it'll just say, cool, we've done it for you. And then you're like, okay, well, where's the CSS, man? So that'll help you out with that. So let's try this. Okay, it's analyzing the page, of course, and then it's going to generate this code to go ahead and apply the styles dynamically. And there you go. Everything has been centered. And there is all the CSS you need to go ahead and implement this. So you can just copy and paste that again in your theme options in the actual module with the custom code, custom CSS on the advanced tab. And that was easy enough. Now, another thing that I see a lot in support tickets, and if you're not using something like Divi Machine that has a setting for this, is to align the last module in a column to the bottom, right? Cool. So we're going to go ahead and inspect this, of course, and I'm going to go ahead and do the manual select here again of the column. And now what I'm going to tell it is that, how do I keep the image at the top of this column and move the button to the bottom? Okay. And then again, give me the full CSS at the end. Let's see what it does. Okay. Spit out the code, and simple as that. It goes ahead and does that for you. It's so easy. And there you go, is all the CSS again. So simple. So I think you guys can see how this is a very helpful tool for you to control the front end of your site and maybe achieve some settings that Divi doesn't have natively. But of course, this is not limited to Divi. You can use this with any WordPress site. You can use it with Elementor. You can use it with Bricks Builder, anything out there, as long as it uses Chrome or you're running Chrome. So that's a super simple thing. This is free, which is insane. And that's kind of all I wanted to show you today. Now let those imaginations flow. Definitely let me know in the comments if you want me to explore the other things like the network sources or the performance tabs and the other features here within the AI assistant in Google Chrome. Of course, guys, go ahead, like, subscribe, comment, check out divengine.com. It's been awesome having you. It's good to be back, baby. And I will see you in the next video real soon. Bye for now.